Hello and welcome back. In this lesson, we're going to create an SSH key pair. This will be used by the Linux VM resource we created so that we can SSH into it later. So let's get started. All right, as you can remember from the docs, we've got the admin SSH key right here. So that's all we have to do. We just have to create the key first. So let's head back into our terminal, actually. Let's go ahead and run an SSH keygen -t RSA. We're going to create an RSA key pair. All right, and I want to save this users derek.ssh. And again, this is Windows, which is why this might look a little bit different, but you'll want to just save it in the same path that's illustrated here. We're just going to rename it. So slash, I'll just name mine MTC Azure Key, just like so. Not going to bother with a passphrase there. And we're all set. So if I run an ls home slash dot ssh, you can see my MTC Azure Key and MTC Azure Key.pub are there ready to go. Perfect. So go ahead and clear my screen there. And then what I want to do is add that key pair, and I'm actually going to put that above this OS disk just to keep it consistent with the documentation, but it really doesn't matter as long as it's within the MTC VM block. So admin SSH key, username equals admin user, as we remembered before, and public key equals. And now we're going to use a Terraform function. So just like any other programming construct, it basically is the name of the function followed by parentheses. So we're going to use the file function. And what the file function does is reads a file and substitutes its contents for the value here. So what we'll use is we'll use our MTC Azure key.pub, since it wants the public key right here, and we're going to read that using the file function. Make sure you wrap that in quotes. So file is going to pull the contents out of this MTC Azure key.pub and insert those into this argument here. So it's going to fill this out for us. Now, if you want to check out the docs, you can check them out here. Pretty straightforward, as you can see. You basically just pass the path into the file function. And there are also some other functions, Filebase64, which we may look into very soon, file exists, and template file. All right, so now that we have done that, we now have a way into our instance. So now let's go ahead and apply and make sure that we can log into our instance. So I'm going to run my Terraform format once again to clean all of that up. Then I'm going to run Terraform plan. Let's make sure everything is looking good. All right, beautiful. As you can see, one to add, everything is looking good. As you can see here, the file function did exactly what it was supposed to do and added this here doc syntax to the beginning and end of it. So that is great. Everything is looking good. So let's go ahead and run a Terraform apply. Auto approve. All right, all set. Everything applied correctly, which is just wonderful. So now let's go and see if we can find that IP address. Let's just run once again a Terraform state list. And we've got our brand new virtual machine right here. Go ahead and copy that. And then Terraform state show and paste that in. And if we scroll up here, we can see we've got our public IP address for our instance right here. Perfect. Go ahead and copy that. Let's clear the screen and then let's SSH-I and pass in that MTC Azure key that we had. Admin user was the username we specified at, and paste that IP address in. All right, you may have had a confirmation screen. Go ahead and click yes if you did. Otherwise, here we are, all logged in. And if I run an lsb underscore release dash a, we can see we are now within our Ubuntu instance. All right, perfect. So I'm going to exit out of that. Clear my screen once again, and that is all for this lesson. Go ahead and mark it complete. Come on back to the next one, and let's continue building.